This video is sponsored by Squarespace. From websites and online stores to marketing tools and analytics, build your online presence with Squarespace.
Hey everyone, Ace of Clay here. Welcome back to my channel and welcome to another sculpting video. Today, I'm making Sally from The Nightmare Before Christmas. Now, I got a lot of really good feedback on my Jack Skellington and Oogie Boogie sculptures from this past October, so I kind of had no choice but to make Sally now because, of course, what's Jack without Sally? And she's also this really good, like, transition piece because it's, like, in between Halloween and Christmas, and The Nightmare Before Christmas, is it a Christmas movie? Is it a Halloween movie? I don't know. I personally think it's a Halloween movie, but I know that's up for debate. Let me know what you think about that in the comments. And just to give you a quick recap, The Nightmare Before Christmas is my top favorite movie of all time. It introduced me to Tim Burton and Henry Selick, and I love everything about the film. One day I actually hope to have sculpted every single character from the movie. All right, so if you want to see me bring Sally to life, then hit like, hit subscribe, and then if you want more content from me outside of YouTube, be sure to check me out on Instagram and Twitter. I'm at Ace of Clay, and I would love to see you there. Now, without further ado, let's get started. All right, for the first step, just like I did with Jack Skellington, I'm going to sketch her out at the scale I want to sculpt her at. This is just so I can get all the proportions correct. And to get my accurate measurements, I'm measuring body parts against other body parts. And as always, all of the materials and tools that I use in this video are listed in the description box below, along with my affiliate links if you want to purchase anything. Now I'm just going to take my aluminum wire and put it up against my drawing and shape out her torso and legs. After measuring out the arms up against the drawing, I'm going to attach them to the torso with some smaller armature wire. Now to start bulking her out, I'm using some Super Sculpey Ultralight. This is a great medium to get a nice base for my final layer of clay. I'm going to shape out the basic structure for her torso and hip area, and then I'm going to bake this so that when it's hard, I can add my final layer of clay. Now I'm going to add my bamboo skewer for her neck. If I forget this step, I can always drill a hole into this later after it's already cured. It works just fine. This is, of course, easier. And after a little more finessing, it's time to bake her for the first time. And then once she is baked and completely cooled down, it's time to cover her in clay. I'm using Super Sculpey Original for this project, and to get these nice even sheets, I rolled it through my pasta maker on the thickest setting. I'm just going to get a nice layer over that ultralight section, and then we're going to start adding her legs. These are just snakes of clay, and I'm going to attach the upper and lower legs in separate sections. Sometimes, like this instance right here, I like to cut a slit halfway through that snake of clay before I add it to the wire. Sometimes it's easier to attach like this. You can also wrap a smaller gauge wire around your main armature wire to help the clay stick better. Or you can even brush some bacon bond onto that wire, and sometimes this helps too. So whatever works, sometimes it sticks great like this, sometimes it doesn't. It really just depends. I'm just going to bring up my reference photo here really quick, and I noticed that her hip bones are pretty prominent, so we need to go and replicate this on my sculpture, bring up the legs a little bit more with another piece of clay. And then I realized that after doing this, she gets a little anatomically incorrect, but it's okay because she's going to wear a dress and it's going to disguise this. If she were wearing pants, I would have a lot of resculpting to do. Now, one thing I'm keeping in mind as I'm sculpting her is that she has a very, like, mannequin body shape. She kind of reminds me of one of those, like, sewing mannequin kits that's just, like, the torso and, like, a little bit of the legs. And I'm trying to keep that in mind because she's not a perfect, like, human shape. She's still cartoony, so I'm trying to pull from that. And, of course, you know, she's got these tiny little feet, these tiny little hands. But her body, for the most part, is, like, a stylized mannequin. So I just want to run with that. And then after finishing the calves and the shins and all that fun stuff, I actually hate making calves more than I hate making hands. Just want to throw that out there. Now I'm just adding the little kneecap, which finishes off the first leg, and then I'm going to finish the other leg off camera. All right, now I'm going to work my way up and finish her chest. I want to make sure everything is good to go before I add the details for her dress. Now for her dress. I've rolled this sheet of clay through my pasta maker on the thickest setting, and I'm just sort of stretching out the edges to make it a little thinner and more organic looking. And then we're going to cut it down to the shape that I want and cut the little jagged edge for the bottom using my Excel blade. Use code aceofclay at excelblades.com for 15% off your purchase. Best blades and tools ever. Now I'm just going to attach the dress like so and blend that top edge in with the rest of her body. And now that that dress is looking pretty good, let's finish off her arms. And just like we did on her dress, but on a much smaller scale, we are going to attach her sleeves. I pre-cut this out, of course, and I am attaching it to her shoulder like so. Now let's repeat this process on the other side after that arm's finished. Now before I add the neckline of her dress, I'm going to add her neck. And then just kind of stick this on over my skewer and blend it in. Make sure it's good to go. She's got a very long, skinny neck. And now let's finish off her dress using this nice jagged-edged snake of clay that I rolled through my pasta maker on the 4 setting. I'm just adding it on and then blending the one edge in with the rest of her body. There you go. Now she's wearing a dress. Look at that. Now for the fun part, using my explorer tool, I'm going to add all of the stitches to her skin. And for these stitches, I'm not going to add the pieces individually. I'm just going to put an indent in for each one just because I want them to be a little more subtle than the ones I will be adding to her dress. You'll see what I mean in a second. So we're just kind of following the pattern of her dress to the best of our ability. This was a lot harder than I thought it was going to be, not gonna lie, but I think we got somewhere decent. And one thing that I'm very annoyed about is I forget to put these stitches on her legs. Her legs, I just leave them completely normal, and I don't know how I missed this. I didn't want to paint them on after I noticed because I thought that would just look cheesy, so I just left them. Maybe in the future I'll break off her legs and redo them because that drives me nuts. I can't believe I forgot to put the scars on her legs. And now for the painstaking but oddly relaxing process of adding the stitches one at a time to her dress. I'm using a bunch of different tools to do this, being very careful not to smash them. And then we're just going to kind of time-lapse through that really quick. Looking pretty good. Now let's move on to her head. This was by far one of the hardest head sculpts I have ever done. I don't understand why this was so hard for me. I don't know if it was an off day or if she's just that hard to sculpt, because I swear these simple designs are so much harder than more detailed designs. It's not even funny, because if one little tiny thing is off, because the design is so simple, it is so much more noticeable that something is off. So I don't know. I get it to a decent point that I'm happy with, of course, or else I wouldn't be releasing this video. But all in all, it took a very long time to get there. I believe her head took me an entire like 2 hours to do, and it normally takes me like 45 minutes to get a head done. So there you go. Just keep that in mind as you work on your projects. Know that not every sculpture is going to be a breeze. Some are going to come quickly to you, and some are going to take forever and fight you every step of the way. This head fought me every step of the way. Now this is actually the first set of eyes I created for her. I add her nose to see if it'll make me feel better, and it doesn't, so I end up redoing the eyes a little bit, but the nose came out pretty good. It's this sort of like pyramid shape that's sitting in the middle of her face. And then this is actually the second set of eyes that I redid off camera because I was so frustrated. Now I'm going in and adding those little like Dahlia lines to her mouth and then her lips. And then at one point we lost those lines, so let's go ahead and redo those really quick and then add the scar to her eyes and cheek. Then after adding the tiny little stitches to her mouth and eyes, I'm going in and attaching her eyelashes. These are little Y shapes that I bent out of my floral wire that I poked above each eye, like so. She's got four V's on each one. There we go. Her head is as good as it's gonna get. Now I'm going to stick it on with a little bit of Bacon Bond and refine things a little bit more before we move on to her hands and feet. Now let's finish these off with some tiny little socks. Now for her hands, I'm going to use the same process that I always use, but they're just going to be very, very tiny. And I was really surprised to learn that she has 5 fingers on each hand. Normally, like characters like this have 4, every other character does, and this is the first 5-fingered hand that I've made in a very long time. Once everything is good to go, I'm going to go ahead and brush the surface with clay softener to remove fingerprints and then get her ready for another bake. And once she's baked and completely cooled down, she's looking pretty good and it's time to make her hair. For her hair, I'm using Cos clay just so it stays flexible and it's easier for me to paint. So I'm just going to cut out the shape that I want from my flat sheet of Cos clay that I got by rolling it through my pasta maker on the thickest setting. Then we're going to measure it up against her head and then pinch the edges so they're not so straight and make them look a little more organic. And then I'm going to go in with my pin tool and texture the hair. And now I'm going to attach her hair with a little bit of bacon bond. And I have found in my experience that all of Sculpey's products work great with cosplay. You can use bacon bond with it. You can use translucent liquid clay. You can use clay softener. Everything works great. Just don't mix Sculpey with cosplay. They're two completely different clays, not meant for that. I just want to mess with the hair a little bit until it gets into a position that I like. It's sort of just this flat sheet. We're just going to manipulate it just a little bit and then get her ready for her final bake. And once she's baked and completely cooled down, it's time for paint. All the paints that I use in this video and every video really are folk art brand matte acrylics. I'm going to start with all of the skin areas using this very icy light blue. Now I'm going to go in and darken the area around her eyes with some darker blue. And for all of the stitching on her body, I am going in with some greenish sort of robin's egg blue paint and a fine paint brush to highlight those areas. They aren't super prominent like the stitches on her dress, but we do want to make sure that you can see them a little bit. Now I'm going to go in with a larger brush and dry brush some lighter blue on the surface to bring out some of the details and add some highlights. Then we're going to go in and paint her eyes. Now for her lips, I'm using the color Barnyard Red. And with a little bit of black paint on a tiny ball stylus, I'm adding her pupils, making sure she doesn't look cross-eyed. Now let's paint her eyelashes. I loved this step because it really made it look like Sally. And now before I paint all the different patterns on her dress, I'm going in with a medium grayish brown color. This is called Mauve Dust, and I'm putting on a nice primer coat. Now for the next step, I'm going to add a black wash into all of these stitching areas. This is just watered down black paint, and I want to make sure it's into all of those nooks and crannies, and I'm going to wipe off the excess. And I'm doing this now because if I do this at the end, it's going to look like this on the final product, and I want to cover that excess that I'm getting. So I just want to get it into all the cracks, and then here I am for the first section. I am touching up the areas with that Mauve Dust color, and we're going to go in and add all those swirls and finish her dress. finishing off all the patterns on her dress, it's time for her hair. I darkened some barnyard red to get this nice reddish auburn tone. We're gonna go in and paint that. I'm so glad I made the hair out of cosplay because it is so much easier to paint. And then we can't forget to paint our base. Just gonna do this one black. And she's done! My sculpture of Sally from The Nightmare Before Christmas is complete. Let me know what you think of her in the comments. And that's a wrap. I really hope you like how my Sally sculpture came out. I'm pretty happy with her. I think she looks good. I'm glad I used the cosplay for her hair. It made it a lot easier to paint. And I'm also glad that I made her to scale with Jack. One day I actually hope to mount both of them to the same base and kind of create this like scenery piece around them. So stay tuned for that. But yeah, let me know what you think of her in the comments. And then before we close out, let's talk about our sponsor, Squarespace. Whether you're just getting started or you're an established brand, the Squarespace commerce platform supports the way you do business. Whether you're looking to sell products directly or even build for your services, they've got you covered. For me personally, I love Squarespace for their portfolios. I am constantly updating my website with new photos of my work, and I love how customizable the galleries are. And I also want to mention their amazing email support team that is available 24 hours a day, 7 days a week. They're an actual team in an office, and they will typically respond to your questions within an hour. So if all of this sounds good to you and you're ready to take the leap and make a website, then head on over to squarespace.com/aceofclay to save 10% on your first purchase, because who doesn't love saving money, especially on a really cool website? And as always, thank you so much for watching and being here. Be sure to like, comment, and subscribe, and then follow me on Instagram, Facebook, and Twitter at aceofclay. I'm also on TikTok, so check me out there, and I will see you in the next video. Thanks for watching.